UFC lightweight division bout. No denying this man's striking credentials. Prevailing wisdom is he's going to try to keep this fight standing tonight.
He has to. You know, this is what got him to the show. It was being able to use the hands to set up the kicks. We all talk about the high-level boxing background of this young man. But as he's developed great knees.
Yeah.
He's developed great timing, great counter skills, and also the beautiful right high kick. The right high kick is something he hides very well as he follows with a jab, right hand, left hook. High kick comes over the top, and he can put you to sleep.
No doubt about it. He will try to put on a striking clinic once again here tonight. Most exciting man in mixed martial arts today. My fantasy football team is Team Gaethje. Justin Gaethje, since signing with the UFC a few years ago, has absolutely taken this promotion by storm.
And he's only in main events. He's only in main events because you know, when you put Justin Gaethje at the top of the marquee, people will show up to watch in the arena, but they will also tune in on their television sets, on their computers, their laptops, on your PS4 or your Xbox, regardless of the console. People will show up to watch Justin Gaethje fight. All action fighter, has great wrestling, but it's his boxing and his leg kick that has truly made him special for fight fans all around the world.
And now our tale of the tape for this lightweight fight. 2 years apart, these two fighters, with some differences in height and a similar reach. All right, we send it inside the octagon to the veteran voice, Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this fight is 3 rounds in the UFC lightweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, a Muay Thai fighter holding a professional record of 12 wins, 1 loss. He stands 5'8" tall, weighing in at 155 pounds, Rafael Fiziev! And now introducing his opponent, fighting out of the red corner. This man is a kickboxer, holding a professional record of 23 wins, 4 losses. He stands 5'11" tall, weighing in at 155 pounds. And when the action begins, our referee in charge, Eve Loving.
The veteran Eve Loving draws the assignment here.
You ready?
All right, here we go. Round one, outstanding matchup of strikers. Any chance this thing hits the canvas?
I don't believe so. I think when you have two high-level strikers like you have in these two men, they're going to go to the center of the octagon, and it's going to be a kickboxing match. A kickboxing match that you would see in a ring. Tonight, you get to watch it inside of an octagon.
Oh, nice slip to avoid that right hand. Oh, that's a big connection for Justin Gaethje, and really just loves being in that octagon. I'm not sure anybody loves fighting that as much as Gaethje.
People don't enjoy being in someone's face, getting punched and landing punches as much as Justin Gaethje. He's right where he wants to be. Right hand punch with the clinch. Big, powerful punch lands. Now we get back to range.
Oh, beautiful strike attempt there as he lands the hook.
Beautiful hook. Really did a great job of keeping his back hand on his chin, throwing that hook and putting it exactly where he needed to go.
Oh, caught him flush with the head kick.
What a kick by this young man. He does a great job of disguising that technique, and before you know it, boom, he lands.
Just misses with a left hook there.
It's very tricky when he throws that body kick. Big punch lands over the top. How's he gonna follow this one?
Able to land with the left hand there. Oh, nice jab by slam there, and I guess on the other side, hard to get your offense going when your head keeps getting snapped back like a pest dispenser.
Every time he tries to go forward and use his own offense, the jab is stopping him in his tracks. He's doing a great job of fighting behind him. Right hand punch.
Oh! Big shots exchanged in the pocket there. 26 total strikes have landed for Justin Gaethje. Mixes it up nicely in terms of staying heavy and also staying active. Just misses there with the left.
Ooh, big shot to the body.
And they separate.
Oh, big punch lands.
Oh, he got that inside leg kick to the target there, DC. You don't want to eat too many of those.
No, you can't. It starts to beat up the inside thigh. That is a technique you use to really slow down your opponent.
A huge block there.
He loaded up on that right hand, too.
Trying to hammer that lead leg.
Big hook.
Oh, nice jab.
Good fight here. Under two to go. No. Combination lands. Hard to see a miss in that sequence. He's put it all together.
I mean, everything is just flowing. He's like in a zone. It's like the basketball hoop becomes twice its size. This guy today is looking at focus and in his opponent. Nice.
And now his opponent in a world of trouble.
Such a sneaky head kick. He did not recognize God. And now he's got him hurt bad. Nice kick.
He lands another leg kick there. He's already landed several in this round, and the damage is really starting to take its toll.
Yeah, it's really starting to take its toll. And you watch the opponent walking gingerly on his legs, and one big tell that you're starting to really do well with your leg kicks is when your opponent starts to switch stances.
Right.
Watch for a stance switch very soon. Nice strike.
Single collar tie now. Well, he has certainly found the range and staying pretty busy here on the field.
He's being busy, but it's also the top. Dude's hurt. Serve him up. Go get him.
Oh!
Nice kick. These guys are going at it.
And both of them. Oh, straight right. Just unable to quite find that range.
Look at him chopping the wood. Chop the wood with those leg kicks.
Oh, huge Superman punch.
Look at him whip his hip into that kick.
Right hand upstairs. 5 minutes in the books. Kicking game was outstanding in that round. We'll see if his opponent can make the adjustments, but take us through the replays before we get there.
It's always weird to watch a young fighter start to come into his own. Early in his career, he did not have this ability. He did not have the ability to dictate and control fights with his legs. Now he does, and he looks like a future champion in the making.
All right, we'll see how it goes here in this next round. A high number of kicks landed there in the previous round, and at some point, these are going to really start to take
effect. They do start to take an effect whenever you're taking kick after kick after kick. And watching him fight with that knowledge and that patience shows his fight IQ.
Lands with a right hand. Oh, there he goes, attacking that lead leg to the outside. Nasty kick there.
Nasty leg kick. You got to slow down your opponent. He knew his opponent wanted to move a lot tonight. This is the first step in getting him to slow down and fight at your pace. That's a big strike right there. Now he's on top of him looking for a finish.
All right, he's trying to control posture here. Now trying to hip escape.
He's just trying to move out of this position off the bottom.
All right, working inside the closed guard now. Useful strike there. The ground and pound on point tonight. just sort of hanging out here unguarded, DC. Not sure if he's trying to bait him in or what, but not great body language here. He's having his way with him here. Back to the feet now.
Big leg kick.
Oh, nice connection there with a punch, DC.
Great time to land that punch.
Just out of range with that left hook. 3 minutes to go in the round. So a much different approach from him here in round two. Took him a while to find the range, get in his striking rhythm. He has found it here, and as a result, has really picked up the pace in round two. How good is that right hand?
Big body kick lands.
Oh, beautiful combination of kicks.
Nice straight punch.
And they separate. Oh, rips the body shot there. He landed the right hand there. And back to his feet.
Back to clinch position. This is where he has done a ton of good work here. Punch, punch, punch to the head.
Oh! Oh, straight right. Trying to kick the leg out. Strong punch there by Gaethje. Man, the body work really starting to take its toll here. Obvious redness on that right side. Gaethje's attempt there is blocked by the opponent.
Real sneaky head kick gets in there.
Slipped that offering from his opponent. In the past, we've seen him sort of lean on the toughness. Tonight, he's leaning on the defense.
And you see the evolution of the fighter in front of us. He doesn't have to be tough anymore. The more he can slip strikes, the longer he can prolong his career.
Nice punch there by Gaethje. Big straight left. Oh, he continues to land a high number of strikes in this round. Really hasn't let up when it comes to his aggressiveness. Certainly have to be mindful that you don't gas out, but you gotta like the output on display here. Just misses with the right. Single collar tie now.
Right hand punches the clinch. Beautiful strike. Big body kick.
15 seconds. Oh, now he stuns him beautifully with the left hand.
The left hand is so accurate and so educated. He's so fight. Both fighters.
10 minutes in the books. All right, so a crowd-pleasing 5 minutes in the books. DC, take us through some of the highlights.
Punch after punch landed right on his opponent's face. Did a great job of finding his target, locking in, and then getting his fist to the target in that round.
Strike lands there.
Great punch.
Oh, big knee to the body. That'll soften him up.
Oh, nice elbow.
Now connects with a right. Visibly limping here. guard lands the right hand. Well, straight right hand has been a good weapon for him. Dominating this fight, the stamina still on point. He didn't skip those VersaClimber days, that's for sure.
No, this has to feel good. This has to feel like everything we did.
Goes down again. Oh, big left hook there. Oh, well, both fighters pretty comfortable on the ground, DC, but you got to be very careful hanging out here for too long if you're his opponent. There as he decides to stand up and relinquish the dominant position. All right, good movement by him here on the ground. He really is a master of these transitions.
He is a master of movement on the ground. You never know where he's going
to
be.
All right, bottom fighter here, maybe looking to hip escape, DC. Oh, and he escapes up to his feet. Very nice. Well, not only has he stayed aggressive as he was in the previous round, landing a high volume of strikes, but he's also been efficient, not just with his strikes, but also with his body movement. His leg kick rounds his opponent, tried to stay upright, but man, that changed the complexion of this fight.
Johnny's hurt. He's hurt really badly by that one big leg kick.
All right, late in the fight now, he needs a finish or he's gonna lose this fight tonight. We'll see if he goes for it.
I mean, he's gotta pull out all the stops. There is no more strategy. There is no more time to try to set up a punch. You gotta just start letting everything fly. It almost looked like he went limp there for a second. What a punch.
All right, so he's landed some good shots tonight, but this is not a combo meal, right? Hey, no three-piece, no sodas.
John, don't you come to me without a combo. I want the whole platter. Give him the whole platter, young man. Put some punches together. Make this guy take the whole thing. Give him more than one strike. You have now found a set of punch. The jab is landing consistently. Find something that's going to go behind
him.
He got him. What a fight.
Well, it's not every day in the UFC that you see a fight ended due to a leg kick, but that one was absolutely devastating. He took away that lead leg of his opponent, who became a one-legged fighter, and then it became just a matter of time. So somewhat anticlimactic here tonight, but not for the winner, as he gets one of the bigger TKO wins of his UFC career. So a big win for him here tonight, and an even bigger statement made by virtue of the TKO.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Ian Levine has called a stop to this contest at 3 minutes, 27 seconds of the third round, declaring the winner by TKO, Rafael!
Imagine what the celebration is like in his hometown right now after he gets the TKO win tonight. He said he wanted to leave the judges out of it. Mission accomplished.
Mission accomplished. He left the judges out of it. The judges could have went to the concession stand because once he got his opponent hurt, he was not going to stop until he got that TKO.